G'day, my name's John. I'm one of the tour guides for MEET, the Marmots Exposed Eco Tours for the Whistler-Blackcomb region. That's where we are right now. And today we're going to go up to the mountain and I'm going to introduce you to some facts about marmots and black bears that you may not be aware of. Maybe we'll also look at some other creatures. Ah, beautiful. So you notice this this old man's beard here, this lichen, it's black. One of the things I love about black comb is it's black lichen. And just like its greener cousin, this stuff makes great menstrual pads. Beautiful for soaking up wounds, any kind of wounds if you get stung by a salmon or anything like that. And best of all, makes beautiful bush tucker. Just boil yourself up a nice pot of water, stick some of this old man's beard in, and you'll be set for the day. So we're about halfway on our trip now. I'm going to show you something. Eagles are very keen arborists, as you can see here. Also keen Egyptologists. The upside down question mark tree, it's been shaped over a number of years by a bald eagle. It means, am I dreaming? They're kind of surreal birds, and as you can see, also obsessed with death and the apocalypse. This eagle's formed this lump of kind of dead tree and dirt into a guest mosque, but then there's a tree growing out of the top, so they're also quite positive too. They do believe in growth and healing, and yeah, pretty good birds. I'm just going to show you a bit of the tree line trail, give you a snippet. This here's a marmot hole, and you can see that this little marmot's out right now doing his business for the day. If it was nighttime, he would have pulled this little rock over the entrance. It'd be safe from predators, and they're very smart marmots. I'm actually going to show you how they've become symbiotic with the black bear in this area. Follow me down. I've got my shirt off, by the way, because I just don't feel right having a shirt on when I'm close to nature, and please don't let that put you off. So, as I was saying, the marmots are quite ingenious. If you can pan down here, this structure here would be used by marmots in the months of February and October. Now this is the season when the bears are actually giving birth, and a lot of people don't know that this area right here is very popular with the bears. They'll be flying over and giving birth to up to 8 baby bears at a time. The problem with this, well, there's lots of problems, but one of the main ones is that the bears come down, they're not fully developed yet in terms of their wings, and so they need some kind of system to cushion them. So the marmots will build a little trampoline in an area like this. You get your baby bear bouncing off, and also doubles as a way to give them that little boost so that they can give their first flap. One thing you've got to know about the bears is, particularly during the mating season and when they're giving birth, they do have particularly large saucer-like eyes. They actually do look like plates. And one of the problems is, if you're a bit peckish, if you've been hiking out for a while, it will remind you of scrambled eggs or some kind of nice small breakfast, and you get a bit hungry. If you do get annoyed by the bears, just shake your keys. Just shake your keys around. They hate the sound of responsibility, and they'll be off in no time. I just think the final detail, I don't really want to spoil it for you, because MEET is a very educational tour, and I just want to give you a little flavour of the kind of information you'll be getting. But one thing you should know is that the marmots are very sociable animals. They've actually emulated a lot of the behaviour that you get down at the village, and they've developed over 150 new STIs. We're really trying to look out for that. A lot of the marmots are suffering right now. And I just want to say thanks for watching. Thanks for watching MEET. And just remember, Marmots Exposed Eco Tours, MEET. We'd love to meet you again, and just give you some more information about marmots, black bears, and other indigenous wildlife in this area. I hope to see you soon. G'day.